a while too, let's
Yeah.
be honest. I mean, they're gonna keep going. So right now, we're gonna send it back to the wall with Ryan Alice and your snowfall.
All right, thank you, Tyler. Let's go ahead and take a look at our updated model projection of how much snow is going to fall here across Iowa. If you take a look real quick here. Here it comes. It starts to come out of the central part of Iowa, and as you can see here, it aims about 9. You know what? Personally, I'm going to adjust these up maybe 2 to 3 more inches. So in Ames, I'd expect more around a foot. But the general idea here is correct. You know, we have this very large band of snowfall that just comes up here into Wisconsin. And you can see it's extensive. It comes from all the way from Omaha all the way up into Wisconsin, and it's just not going to let up. This storm system will continue into tomorrow, as you see. But now let's take a look at those winds. And I want you to really pay close attention to how long these lines are. The longer the lines, the stronger the winds. You can really see here, here's that counterclockwise flow, meaning there's a very, very strong area of low pressure around. And if we put this into motion, you can see here, here's these lines. They start to get longer, and that is indicating some very high winds that are just going to move in. And as Matt said, behind it, we're going to have very cold conditions. And as Tyler said, you know, in Nebraska right now, they're seeing that drifting snow. That's unfortunately what we're going to be seeing here in Ames come into the early morning hours tomorrow. And this is just not going to let up. It's a very good chance that this drifting snow is going to make, you know, snow totals accumulations seem higher than they actually are. Let's take a look at our forecast jet stream. Here it is. Here's our large trough that you see here. And unfortunately, when this trough gets this deep like this, we have that very cold air, and it's just plunging down. Arctic's cold is now open to come down into the Midwest, as you see. And if we put this into motion, you can see it's just not going to stick around. It's actually going to deepen a little bit more, make cold air persist here in Iowa. I think the only good news is we start to see that ridge off over here. That maybe might warm us up, but in the foreseeable future, not going to look too good for us. Otherwise, let's go ahead and take a look at this low. I think the one thing that you should really keep your eye on are these lines. They're so close together, meaning that we have a tight pressure gradient, as Sam said. And I've never really seen this type of pressure gradient before. This means very, very strong winds. If I put this in motion, it gets even stronger. If you take a look here, that is really, really strong. What it does in meteorology, we call that a bomb, meaning that surface flow just explodes in power. This is quite a fascinating system, definitely one we're going to remember. As you see, it does quickly move off to the northeast, giving us a break finally. Fortunately, through our day, we're not going to have great conditions. Now let's take a look at our forecast tonight. Snow and high winds. That's the bottom line. We have winds out of the northwest from 25 to 30. It's going to slowly pick up overnight. This gust is to 40. You can almost probably guess maybe even to 50. That's kind of the numbers have kind of slowly creeped up. And you could definitely expect maybe even tropical storm force gusts, which I know sounds crazy, but it's certainly possible considering how strong that pressure gradient is. The low is not going to get too cold. That's because of how strong those winds are and the clouds, 10 degrees. But if you keep in mind the wind chill values, they're going to be well below zero. So frostbite, certainly a factor. You shouldn't be outside anyways during the storm tonight. Tomorrow, the winds are going to continue. The snow will end at noon, so that's the only good news. But again, the winds are going to stay strong. We have the gusting even higher tomorrow. Snow's going to stop, however. We're going to have those winds continue. Very cold temperatures. Certainly no one's going to be outside tomorrow. Hopefully they do cancel school. Not that I'm going to give any information away regarding that, because I have no idea. Temperature tomorrow, we're going to get to 13. Not much of a change. The temperatures are going to stay fairly consistent. Now let's go ahead and take a look at our extended forecast. You see here, unfortunately, we do have temperatures just staying cold. A little bit of a warm up on Saturday, but otherwise, this is just ugly weather. The really good news, though, is no more snowfall throughout the rest of the week. So with more information regarding our blizzard of 09, let's take it back to the desk.
Thank you very much, Ryan. And actually, speaking of updates, we just got an update from actually from SciRide itself.
Yeah, I'm following SciRide on Twitter, and they just sent out a message about a minute or two ago. The Orange and Cardinal bus stops at the MU have been closed. However, all other bus stops on campus are open. So if you need to catch the Orange or Cardinal, go, and you're at the MU, you might want to go to another stop.
Yeah, they're starting to shut down the road.
And then, yeah, because they said it was due to some road closures on campus.
Yeah.
So be really careful of where you're looking at. And also, if you want to take Blue North to get to Shaletter or University Village, those are also closed. However, Blue South is still normal, which I can't quite figure
Mind-boggling.
Out.
Mind-boggling.
Well, because
I don't know,
they take the exact same road. But if you want to catch Blue North, I think it's taking the brown stop on Stang
okay,
Road.
Yeah.
So
well,
you can use the brown stop, and then it'll turn on to 13. whatever street that is up there and go to the mall.
People should just stay inside tonight. I mean, it's all, you know, try not to be out
just
driving,
don't go
trying to catch the bus.
To.
I mean, it's just it's too chaotic outside to be out there and trying to catch bus. There's nothing open anyway on campus.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, like, this important. Library's closed and all that. And actually, we're going to pull up a very special graphic right now. And it has to do with, it's actually provided by Google Maps. Do we have that graph? There it is. Now, what this map means is that if you see these reds, and you see these yellows, and you see these greens. Now, this means, I'm trying to figure out how to explain this. This is all new technology to me, I guess. But it has to do with the traffic speed measured on your cell phone. As you can see, red is, very, very slow, nearly stopped. Yellow is obviously very slow, I mean, under the speed limits. And if you don't see any conditions or, like, any colors on the highways or interstates, that means that there's no report or, you know, there's very light traffic. Obviously, as you can see throughout, 80, 35, all those main interstates, all those main highways you see highlighted are, of course, people out there being very, very careful. I mean, if they have to go somewhere, they might as well take it easy, I guess. But, traffic is running very, very slowly, as you see, throughout the entire state. I mean, especially here around Des Moines and Ames, and even up into northern Iowa, even into some of western Iowa too. And obviously with those car accidents that were out there earlier today, as well as those semi crashes, people who have to be out, they're going to have to just be careful, bottom line.
Well, the big thing about this storm is, it's so big that you can't travel, 40 miles to get away from it. It's
right.
A cost, the whole United States. You can't, it's not something you can just get through in an hour time, so.
Yeah, if you have to go somewhere tonight, but I don't recommend
right.
it, but
especially
take your time, I guess. Get out there plenty of time early and whatnot. But actually, I think we do, apparently, we have a video we're going to go to. So if we want to roll this new video, that'd be awesome.
Rachel Witter and Sam Schreier here with me. And as you can see, guys, it is just, it's still snowing.
It's still coming down. And if you look over there really quick,
look,
there's a little...
Turn around. Look, little tornado going.
That's just the buildings, folks. The winds actually died down quite a bit from what it was earlier.
Yeah,
although, they are going to pick up as the evening progresses. And if you look out towards the road there, not a whole lot going on, not a lot of cars going by.
Good thing.
You should not be out there as of now.
Look at these roads. They are not even drivable, actually, I don't think. I mean, there's like 3 inches right on the road. So, if this is definitely on the interstate, you should not be outside because, you can easily slip and slide on these roads. And
folks, let's actually take a quick look at how much snowfall we've got so far.
Got it.
Now, when you're measuring snow, it's important to pick an area that's been undisturbed. Like, the road is not a good place. All right, so we're looking at 9.25 inches of snow.
And
a quarter. That's fallen like another inch and a half since they last took the measurement at Sizeyes. That's only been an hour or so.
Only been an hour, so an inch and a quarter,
an hour. So, folks, you need to stay inside. We cannot enforce this enough. And it's getting to the point where you need to keep track of your pets. Make sure they're safe, too, okay?
This is not a system to take lightly, really. If you're going to be out driving tonight, you're going to be slipping around, sliding a lot, but make sure you have a nice little blizzard kit in your car if you must travel. I don't advise it whatsoever, but blankets, extra food, make sure your gas tank is full, and
for sure.
Do not go on long-distance trips whatsoever. These roads are not anything to be taken as a joke. This is a very dangerous condition right now.
Yeah.
All right, thanks for watching us. We're going to send it back to the desk. Tyler.
Well, thank you for that very nice video update. And right now, I'm being joined by Rachel. Rachel, we actually have some updates right now as far as accidents are concerned because of this major blizzard. Actually, earlier, one death was reported from icy conditions and a two-vehicle crash. That happened earlier today, as well as this one happened north of Story City. Two were hurt in a semi-rollover crash, and there were multiple crashes reported associated with that and some other accidents as well. And also, there will be no towing. They're actually pulling the tow trucks off the roads.
Now, I heard earlier that Des Moines had stopped actually sending out plows to the roads, too. So that's just, they're not going to make the roads any better. So
No. That's
something that you definitely have to take seriously and not go out. That's a sign that you should definitely stay at home, not go out by any means whatsoever. There's no reason that anyone should really be outside at this time, in this type of conditions, really.
Well, absolutely. And when the Iowa DOT issues the road conditions and it says travel not advised, travel is not advised. I don't know why people think they need to go outside and go driving. It's just very unsafe, not only for themselves, but for others as well.
Yeah, and those roads are not only covered by snow. There is snow cover on the roads, but underneath that is a small layer of ice. So that's definitely dangerous. Tires will be spinning, fishtailing going on. So not anything safe by any means.
And when that snow blows across the road because of these wind conditions that are going to be occurring fairly soon, then
There's no hope.
That's why they pulled the plows off the road.
Especially those rural roads, too, because the cornfield's very flat, so that snow's just going to blow right across, and that's going to cause drifting heading into the overnight and into early tomorrow morning as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And actually, as a side note, MSNBC, we all know MSNBC, they actually did a news story on Des Moines in this big winter weather storm. And they said that, I mean, they're talking about drifts up to 8 to 15 feet high in some areas. I mean, you know, this is obvious. I mean, this is like a national story, so to speak. I mean, everybody's talking about it. I mean, this is a big deal.
This is a very, very dangerous and very historic almost event here in the Midwest. We're going to see lots of snow, huge blizzard conditions.
Yeah.
I mean, we're talking our whole state is under a blizzard warning, mm-hmm. and that extends even into other states, to our west, to our east, to our south. So
yeah, it's just unbelievable.
Very widespread bad conditions.
Yeah, it's horrible out there. We're going to send it to the wall with Liz right now. First and stuff. There we go.
Thanks, Tyler. I guess first we're going to look at weather headlines. And obviously, heavy snow is expected overnight. A lot of that's supposed to taper off by tomorrow morning. But that's also the same time that the wind is supposed to pick up. And that's going to give us blizzard conditions for tomorrow. And as we said before, blizzard conditions are 1/4 or less miles of visibility and 30 miles sustained winds for at least a period of 3 hours. So definitely keep your eye on the winds. And if once that snow starts blowing, especially if there's still snow coming down, that's going to cause major visibility problems. And we're expecting it to be near zero. So definitely be careful if you absolutely have to go on the roads, although that's not advised. And then again, you can see Wednesday night, we're actually supposed to drop below zero. I believe the cold temperature for Wednesday night is anywhere between -7 and -3 degrees. So pretty cold for Wednesday night. Obviously, that's getting affected by all the snow we're getting. We look at the road conditions. You can really see most of the state travel is not advised, which is this orange color. And the pink is 50. The pinkish color is about 50% covered in snow. So I can almost guarantee that as the night continues, this orange is going to start to creep its way through the rest of the state. And you can see Quad Cities aren't getting it as bad yet. They just have a little bit of snow on the roads. But again, this orange color is ice and mixed with snow on the road, which creates very slippery conditions. So definitely keep your eye on the DOT for more road updates. And finally, we'll take a look at warnings. And as you can see, that blizzard warning continues for the entire state of Iowa through 6 p.m. tomorrow night. So definitely be prepared for very high winds. I know there's potential for gusts up to 60 or 70 degrees or miles per hour. And again, this is even extending up into Minnesota and even into eastern Nebraska. So very large area of snow being covered. And I think now we're going to take a look at the radar. And you can really see there's that little bit of clearing going on right here. But it's basically immediately followed by another area of snow. So this heavy snow is going to move out now and give us a little bit of a break, but only for maybe an hour or two. And then this next band of snow is going to make its way north into central Iowa and give us a lot more snow. So I think we'll send it back to Tyler at the desk.
Thank you very much, Liz, for those very important updates, up-to-the-minute updates. And I'm being joined by Sam once again.
Well, thank you, Tyler.
You're welcome.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Oh, absolutely. We don't want to be anywhere else.
No.
We're going to go ahead and we're going to take a look at updated snowfall totals, which we have pulled up. And this is on a very nice map provided by.
It's a beautiful map, Tyler.
Absolutely. And look at, as you can see, those oranges and reds are the deeper amounts, the more snow that has fallen. And that has been in southwest Iowa. I know, obviously, in northeast Iowa, it's been a little less. Northwest Iowa has seen a decent amount as well. But obviously, southwest Iowa has obviously seen the brunt of this storm so far. And this is just, these are just updates. I mean, that's not obviously final tolls by any means. But I mean, still, nonetheless, a lot of snow.
Start with
and especially for that coming all at once. I mean, you know, we had a really nice November, beautiful November. And now we roll into December, only about a week into it, and then bam, the big, big, big winter storm.
I had a friend telling me, oh, this is going to be such a mild winter. This is going to be such a mild winter just based off of November. And I'm like,